Shalom, shalom to all of you who are listening to me this morning. My name is Chris Nikumana. I'm the host of the Kanguka broadcast. Today is Friday, and I'd like to share with you a very encouraging verse that shows that everyone has the possibility of going to heaven. Let me tell you that heaven wasn't created only for some people. There are some teachings out there that claim that some people were created for heaven and other people were created for hell, but that's not true. It's true that both hell and heaven do exist, but God has given every man and woman the opportunity to go to heaven regardless of where you were born or your ethnic background or your nationality. Every person has the possibility of going to heaven, and let me tell you that, dear brothers and sisters, that this is very good news. In the Old Testament, salvation was limited to Israel. If you weren't a Jew, it wasn't possible for you to get access to heaven and to receive eternal life. But ever since Jesus died and rose again, all of us from Africa and Asia and Europe and everywhere else in the world, we now also have the possibility of going to heaven. That's why the Word of God says that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in Him may not perish but have eternal life. Many people are familiar with that verse in John chapter 3 verse 16. But please hear me well. It doesn't mean that everyone who ever lived on this earth will go to heaven. It's only those who believe in Him who will have access to heaven. The whole world has the possibility of going to heaven, but there is only one way to go to heaven, and it is written in John chapter 14 verse 6, and the way is Jesus. Believing in Jesus Christ is the only way you can get to heaven. There is no other way. Even though Jesus has died for all humanity, it's only those who believe in Him and who have repented who will be able to access heaven, and they will live for all eternity without any sufferings. Their tears will be wiped away, and they will live in everlasting joy. I want all the listeners to understand that nothing here on earth compares to heaven. In heaven, there is everlasting joy. You won't get tired in heaven. You won't cry. You won't suffer. You won't have any regrets. It will be a place of rest. Many people are tired. The world is tired. But true rest can only be found in Jesus alone. That's why there is only one way, and it's true repentance. I will say it again. You need to repent. So what does it mean to repent? It means that you acknowledge that you are a sinner and you express your willingness to abandon your sins with the help of the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit who will enable you to abandon your sins, because you can do it on your own. But you need to come to Jesus just as you are. Proverbs chapter 28 verse 13 says, "He who covers his sins will not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy." You have to confess or acknowledge that you are a sinner. Do you admit that you are a sinner? Do you accept that you've committed sins and that you've sinned against God? I want you to understand that your body doesn't belong to you, but it belongs to God. It's the temple of God. That's why you're not allowed to do whatever you want with your body. If you're involved in sexual immorality, it means that you're destroying the temple of God. If you speak words that don't bring honor to God, you should also repent. You should repent from doing all the bad things that you're doing, whether it's murder or anything else. Repenting means that you accepted that you are a sinner, and once you accepted it, you get on your knees and you call on Jesus so He can come into your life. When Jesus comes into your life, the Holy Spirit will come in you, and He will strengthen you and empower you. He will give you a new identity, and He will transform you into a new person. The Word of God says that you become a new creation. Your external appearance doesn't change, but your spirit will change. Your heart will be transformed. You will have the assurance that if you die in Christ, you will go to heaven and you will have eternal life. Let me tell you that nothing compares to knowing that if you die, you will go to heaven. You're no longer afraid of death because you know that you have Jesus in you. That's why I want you to believe in Jesus Christ. If you want to accept Jesus, you should do it now that you still have the opportunity to do it. As I keep telling you, there will come a day when Jesus will come to take his church. That day will mark the end of the current period of grace, and it will be very hard to get saved after that day because there will be a lot of persecution. But you can accept Jesus today. Just get on your knees and call on him and stop all the sinful things that are separating you from God. You need to quit the things that are binding you, like alcohol or drugs or fornication or homosexuality or hate. Kneel down and repent. You can do it right where you are, or if you need assistance from a man of God, you can give us a call at +256 7813 77337. Now in the second part of the broadcast, and we're going to continue our teaching on deliverance from fear, which started last Monday. We need to learn how to be set free from fear, because there are so many people who are living in fear. If you have fear, you become weak. Maybe you are fearful because you heard some bad news or you saw something that scared you. The more fear you have, the more you lose hope. That's why I want you to have victory over fear. But please hear me well. I'm not saying that if you don't have fear, you won't have any problems. No. Even if you don't have fear, you can still go through problems because God has allowed them to happen. Sometimes God can let you go through some problems even though you have faith and you don't have fear. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego went through fire, and I don't think that they had fear. Based on the words they spoke, you can read about their story in Daniel chapter 3. They believed that God was able to deliver them from the hand of the king Nebuchadnezzar, and that's exactly what they said to him. They told him that the God is able to deliver them from his hand, but even if he doesn't deliver them, they never worship the king's idols. In other words, they were saying that they would rather die than worshiping the king's idols. So the king commanded his soldiers to throw them in the fiery furnace. Those three men knew that they could burn to death. They were ready to die. They chose to die serving God. Let me tell you that when you have faith, God will be with you in the midst of your problems. I'm not saying that you won't die or that you won't have any problems, but even when problems come, God will be with you. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were thrown into the fire, but when the king looked in the furnace, he saw a fourth man. It means that the Lord Jesus Christ will always be with you in the midst of your problems. No matter what you face, if you don't have fear, Jesus will be with you. If you go through problems, he will be with you. If you go through hunger, he will be with you. It doesn't matter what you go through. Whether they insult you or persecute you, Jesus will be with you. The beauty of having faith in Jesus is that he will be with you in the midst of all your problems. If he wants to take you out of your problems, he will do it. And if he wants you to go through those problems, he will be with you all along. That's a big benefit of having faith. But if you have fear and you go through your problems filled with fear, then you are no longer opening a door to Jesus so he can be with you in the midst of your problems. You actually opening a door to Satan, and he will come to torment you in the midst of your problems. Satan will fill your mind with bad and discouraging thoughts so you can lose hope. He will convince you that it's over for you and that you have no future. But you need to know that your God has good thoughts over your life. He has given us a very important promise in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, and every child of God should know his promise. The verse says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and hope." This is a very important verse. If you know that God has good plans for you, if you know that he doesn't have plans to harm you, but he has plans to give you a future and hope, then even if storms come, even if you go through problems, even if you don't see any good around you, you just need to remember God's promise and you can stand on it. Let me share a secret with you. If you know the promises that God made to you, you need to declare them out loud when you pray. When you're concerned about your future and it seems like all doors are closed for you, you need to declare the words in Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Declare those words with your mouth with faith and assurance without fear. When you make that declaration, the demon of fear will have to flee. All the evil spirits that flooding you with bad thoughts will have to flee. You can see in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 17 that one of the spiritual weapons we have at our disposal is the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. So when you declare the Word of God, when you declare the power of God and the truth of the Word of God, you should remember Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12, which says that God watches over His Word in order to fulfill it. That's why there is power in declaring the Word of God. When you do it, you're creating life in you. On Monday, I will show you another very important promise which has transformed my life and it has allowed me to overcome many problems. If you don't know God's promises, you will miss out on a lot of things. May I am bless you and I wish you all a great weekend. God willing, we continue on Monday. If you want to repent or you're transformed by these teachings, you can contact us by sharing your testimony in order to edify other listeners by contacting us on +256 781 377 337.